Wright, and I'm a professor of physics and astronomy at UCLA, and I work on infrared astronomy and cosmology. Well, the most important information that we get from the cosmic microwave background come from, you know, at the lowest level, its existence. I mean, when I started in cosmology, it was not 100% certain that the Big Bang model was correct. And so with the prediction of microwave background from the Big Bang and the prediction of no cosmic microwave background from the competing theory, the steady state, that was a very important step in our knowledge. And then the second aspect of the cosmic microwave background that's very important is its spectrum is extremely similar to a black body. And so by being a black body, that means that the universe, you know, relatively smoothly transitioned from being opaque to transparent. And then, you know, we actually see effectively an isothermal cavity when we look at it. So it looks very close to a black body. And then finally, in the last, make one other step. You know, the fact that we are moving through the universe can be measured very precisely by looking at what's called the dipole anisotropy of the microwave background. So one side of the sky is slightly hotter, about 3 millikelvin hotter, and one side of the sky, the opposite side of the sky, is colder, about 3 millikelvin colder out of the 3 kelvin. So that means we're moving at approximately 0.1% of the speed of light. And in fact, we now know that very precisely what that value is. It's about 370 kilometers per second. So that's our motion, the solar system's motion, through the universe. And then the final piece of information that we're getting from the microwave background now, in fact, the Planck satellite just gave us more information along these lines, is the measurement of the statistical pattern of the very small what we call anisotropies, or little bumps and valleys in the temperature. So in addition to the 3 millikelvin difference, we actually have sort of plus or minus 100 microkelvin difference in the temperature from different spots. And so when you look at the at these spots and look at their detailed pattern, you can actually see a very prominent feature, which is that there's about a 1/2 degree scale, preferred scale. And that's what's caused by the acoustic waves that were set up by the density perturbations early in the history of the universe and how far they could travel before the universe became transparent. And that's a very strong indicator about the universe. The cosmic microwave background actually has this pattern, you know, a 1/2 degree scale, and that gives you a effectively it's a line of position as you have with celestial navigation. When you do a sextant measurement of one star, you get a line on the map where you are. But you can look at the same pattern. This is the acoustic waves set up in the universe. You see that in the galaxies distribution a lot more locally. We're talking about galaxies that might be a billion light years away, but to cosmologists, that's local. And these galaxies also show the same wave-like pattern. And you can measure that angle at scale locally and compare it to what you see very early in history of the universe. And that gives you a crossing line of position. And that really tells us, you know, where we are in the universe, how much stuff there is. So it tells us that we have this dark energy, which nobody really understands what it is, but we know what it's doing. It's making the universe accelerate in its expansion.
We'd like to thank Lars Peter Hammer, Susie Berg, Steve Grzanich, and Jeff Tropiano, and the many others who contribute to our efforts to bring great space and astronomy content every month. If you want to see extra materials like behind-the-scenes content and full-length raw interviews, you too can become a member of our community. Find out how by clicking here.